Hey, I'm Herald Sports writer Manny Navarro.
And I'm Andre Fernandez.
We're here at Booker T. Washington, the new leaders with the longest winning streak in Dade County history. They got it last week, 38 wins in a row. Time to rewind. All right, Dre, so let's talk about these Tornadoes. Last week, 35-7 over Glade Central. Your impressions of this team now, 38 wins in a row, obviously the most impressive streak ever in Dade County.
Yeah, I mean, it's a credit to the consistency of this program. You look at this team, the coaching staff here has been together a while. Even though Coach Ice Harris went to UM, his son is a reflection of him pretty much, and it's kept the continuity of this team going. There's some new faces on this team, which I wondered how would they gel in the beginning. Good athletes, good talent as usual, but it took maybe a little time to really, really start clicking. The game against Glade Central itself, slow first half, but it happens sometimes. Glade Central does have talent in its own right, but then in the second half you saw the depth come through. A guy like Mark Walton, who was a special kind of running back, to come through and have a huge second half, and here we are again, the rematch, Booker T. Coco. It seems like as usual in Class 4A.
Yeah, 4 years in a row, and this will be the toughest test I think this streak has faced since they took on Central.
Definitely.
So, 8A playoffs last week. I was up at the Flanagan Monarch game, and the game went to overtime, Dre. I mean, unbelievable finish. Tied at 21 late in the game, and then they go to OT, and then the dramatic defensive stand for the Dirty Bird defense for Flanagan.
Yeah, well, that's part of the difference at Flanagan, I think, is that they've been improving. They've been becoming a more complete team. Just the attitude on that team, the toughness factor, definitely, they've never had before Coach Devin Bush got there, the way you see it now. This defense starting to look special, and with that offense, when they're clicking, they probably need to get a little more consistent on the offensive side of the ball because they have the means. They have the receivers, the quarterback and Ryan Stanley, the running game to do it. If it all comes together, we might see them in the Citrus Bowl.
Flanagan, of course, will take on Wellington this week. Down on the south side, Columbus, they end up blanking Coral Gables 22-0 in the rematch. This Columbus team is looking pretty good right now.
Yeah, it definitely is. I mean, you look at it, 22-0 says something against an opponent like Coral Gables. That's a good team. That's a team that in the preseason we thought had a state championship potentiality there. But, you know, little by little, this Columbus team has come together. They're starting to run the football better with Ivan Smith and with Andres Fernandez over there. The defense is clicking right now. They haven't given up a point, an offensive point in 4 games. 9 points in the last 5 games. I mean, if you look at that, that's pretty impressive. And right now, they're on a collision course with another good defense in its own right.
Yeah, Killian takes on Belen and crushes them. This Killian defense, I mean, 7 shutouts now, I guess, for the season, right? Or six?
Six shutouts.
I mean,
they're hoping seven. They're hoping for seven, but we'll see.
We'll see what happens in that game. Going down to 7A, St. Thomas Aquinas takes on Plantation again. Not much of a match.
Yeah, again, the rematch, maybe, you know, numbers-wise, a little closer, but in reality, St. Thomas could have opened it up even more. At the point they hit 35-0, they started to get some backups, some reps in there, and just overmatching Plantation. And it shows you, they've been, I looked up the stat for my column this week, 463-20 is the score since they beat Miramar.
Wow.
That's 9 games of just absolute
complete annihilation
of what they've done. But this week, I think it might be a tad closer because now they got Royal Palm Beach and they're pretty good.
Go down to 6A, game of the week. You were there last week for this one. Central comes back to beat Hallandale. They were down 19-7, but tremendous effort there in the second half.
Yeah, to start off, fantastic job by Hallandale this year. Best season in school history to go 10-0, win the district like that, win the playoff game against Northwestern. And they went in there fearless. They were confident. They got in Central's face early, and they backed it up for 2 quarters. They were, you know, 19-7 at the half. Things were going well. But as soon as that Central defense started swarming to the quarterback, got in Tyler Huntley's face, brought him down a few times, caused some turnovers, everything spiraled. 28 points later, Central's advancing and Hallandale's not.
Defending state champions in 5A, Plantation American Heritage, again, they just keep chugging along, man.
Yeah, it's similar to St. Thomas. It seems like they haven't been challenged, although they were challenged pretty much the whole season, if you look at that brutal schedule. But now, it seems like it's simple for them. I mean, we know it's not going to be once they get to state, but... And I say once they get to state, because right now it doesn't look like anybody's slowing them down. But that team has really come together, and they've done a good job, because we saw some special playmakers graduate last year. The guys that are there now are doing
reloaded, good. Reloaded. We talked about Booker T and what they did last week. 3A Westminster Christian takes on a very good Delray Heritage team. I thought maybe being at least close to home would help them out, but you were right. That didn't happen.
No, the Heritage seemed like too much. I mean, even, you know, I know you saw that early in the season, that they were potentially a team. To me, that's the team that's going to win Class 3A. I mean, hands down right now, yes, Clearwater Central Catholic and some of the other teams there are tough, but this American Heritage team, the years that they've been really good, we've seen what they can do, and I wouldn't be surprised.
All right, that wraps it up for round two. Round three is next.